After understanding some concepts related to artificial intelligence, the main schools of thought, and its brief history, let's take a look at artificial intelligence and some of its related technological applications at various levels. Through this diagram on the left, we can intuitively see that the technology of artificial intelligence spans multiple levels, ranging from the top-level applications, algorithm mechanisms, to some devices and chips in the middle layer, and then down to the bottom layer of our chip production processes, materials, and other technological levels. In terms of some technologies related to artificial intelligence, it is applied in more refined areas, such as at the top-level application stage, where we can see artificial intelligence being used in scenarios involving video images, sound, voice, text control, and so on. In the algorithm layer at the intermediate level, we will see that the main algorithms used in artificial intelligence are still primarily based on technical learning. Deep learning neural networks are a branch of our technical learning. At the same time, we will see that at the chip level, our traditional chips can no longer meet the computational power requirements of artificial intelligence. Along with that, some chips optimized by artificial intelligence algorithms emerged or specifically designed programmable chips are made to meet our artificial intelligence applications. Subsequently, the hardware development trend is to manufacture neural form chips that can better meet our computational needs for deep learning neural networks. On the left side of our map, we can see that besides manufacturing some chips, we also need to consider some equipment related to the chips, as well as some production processes, including technical aspects of its materials, and so on, all of which are the technical aspects related to artificial intelligence that need to be taken into account. Next, let's understand the classification of artificial intelligence. In general, artificial intelligence can be broadly understood from the perspectives of strong AI and weak AI. Strong AI holds the view that it is possible to create a truly intelligent machine capable of reasoning and problem-solving. So, such a machine is considered to have perceptual self-consciousness. It can independently think about problems, formulate optimal solutions, have its own values and worldview system. Therefore, we can see that having its own values and worldview system actually reaches a stage category of human intelligence introspection, right? It is in line with the category of human intelligence that we introduced at the beginning, the category of diverse human intelligence. Next, let's take a look at how we hope our powerful artificial intelligence can possess instincts similar to living organisms, such as some survival and security needs. From this perspective, powerful artificial intelligence can be seen as a new civilization. Now, let's look at the corresponding weak artificial intelligence. Weak artificial intelligence refers to machines that we cannot create true intelligent machines capable of reasoning and problem solving. These machines just appear to be intelligent, but they do not truly possess intelligence or have autonomous consciousness. Therefore, we find that many mainstream applications of artificial intelligence today are in a human-machine collaboration mode, rather than a state where machines can completely replace humans. Currently, there is no clear and unified standard for the classification of artificial intelligence and intelligent machines. In general, they can be roughly divided into four categories. That is to say, our intelligent machines can be likened to thinking and acting like humans, which is a manifestation of our weak artificial intelligence field. If we correspond this to strong artificial intelligence, we hope that this machine can engage in rational thinking and rational actions. Mainstream scientific research focuses on weak artificial intelligence, and generally, we believe that the research field of weak artificial intelligence has already achieved a relatively considerable level of accomplishment. Next, let's take a look at and understand the industrial ecology of artificial intelligence. Here, we will see that if we compare the industrial ecology to a large house, then the work of adding bricks and tiles requires the construction of our infrastructure and basic technology. We can see that at the foundational level, this basic infrastructure not only meets our computing power needs. At the same time, it also provides us with a continuous stream of data support. With data and computing power in place, we will see AI algorithms being implemented in various technical fields. First of all, we will see some mainstream directions of technology, such as computer vision, speech processing, natural language processing, and so on. Moving up a level, artificial intelligence needs to be practically implemented in corresponding industries, such as healthcare, finance, security, entertainment, etc. Applying artificial intelligence. We can see that artificial intelligence involves four elements: data, algorithms, computing power, and scenarios. In our industry diagram, it can be seen that when we talk about scenarios, it actually represents the top-level AI industry applications. Through this diagram, we can intuitively see some subfields of research related to artificial intelligence, which not only include machine learning and some application technologies related to artificial intelligence, but also include some areas such as computer graphics, databases, visualization, and data mining. In such some segmented fields, then we can see, if we want to implement a project of artificial intelligence, then we need to involve these fields, which include so many areas.